I'd like to dry out, but I gotta tell you, with this rain, obviously miserable conditions for fire, but I'm gonna get something working.
Really think we can get a fire going?
I'm confident I'll come up with something. This wet weather and this cold temperature means that all the materials that we need for fire are soaking wet. We need to be smart with what we're gonna gather because I need an apparatus that can create perpetual motion with lots of pressure and speed with the least amount of effort. Pump drill is it.
This birch will make a perfect crossbar for my pump drill. And if I can find a nice dead straight piece, I'll use that for my spindle.
I need some quick cordage.
I prefer natural materials.
Rootlets are gonna work great. Pull them up out of the ground here in this thin sphagnum moss, split it out, and I can lash my entire crossbar together in a couple of minutes.
Whenever you're splitting root, you wanna make sure to get it split evenly in half. If it starts to split one way or the other, bend the thicker piece. That'll pull it towards the middle instead of running out. So with these rootlets, sometimes we play a game back and forth. I'm getting it to split just right.
Using spruce root, Bill is able to latch together a crossbar for his pump drill in order to propel the spindle to create friction against the firewood.
Good sturdy crossbar to take the downward pressure. Just wide enough to slide over the spindle. Can move up and down, but not too much gap or play in it. So this is my primary spindle for my pump drill. And what I really need to make sure of is the fact that, first of all, it's as dry as it can be in this environment. It needs to be straight, and it needs to be just sturdy enough to maintain the amount of downward pressure that I'm gonna put on it repeatedly in order to get this coal lit.
Pump drills are tricky. The weight's too heavy, they're sluggish. If it's too light, they jump. I need to have a weight that I can modify.
I'm gonna stack some layers of bark together to make the counterweight for my pump drill.
Grady and Bill struggle to spark a fire in the hopes of finally drying out and evading hypothermia.
Keep it going, don't stop. I got so much in my eye.
It's there.
Dude. Against all odds, in the worst conditions possible, Bill got an ember.
All right, get fire, bud, get fire. Let me see that orange flame.
Coming. I'm starting to see heavier smoke. It's time to give it just a little bit of oxygen.
Oh, baby. Get it.